Hello, dear friends. The title of my presentation is about Paşalar, famous hominoid locality from Western Anatolia, 32 years of excavation in Paşalar site, which is the richest hominoid locality of the world. And this is one of the specimens found in Paşalar. It's a very beautiful material from Paşalar. Now, let me tell you this brief the history of the Paşalar. Paşalar was found in 1969 by German and Turkish geologists, the group of German and Turkish geologists. They came together on behalf of a project we called the Lignite Deposit Explosion in Turkey, and conducted by German and Turkish geologists. And they discovered more than 80 fossil localities all around Turkey. And within these localities, in 1965 and between 1968, they found the Paşalar site. Again, first excavations conducted, carried out by the famous paleontologist, German paleontologist, by Heinz Tobin and his team, and the preliminary result of the finalists, which at that time included 47 micro and micro mammalian taxa, were announced by subsequent papers. In 1983, the excavation restarted. For almost 10 years, excavation till 1983, excavation was stopped under the direction of Professor Berna Alpagut and on behalf of Turkish Ministry of Culture and Tourism and Department of Antiquities and the University of Ankara. And they got all the permits and related stuff. Then they start excavating the locality. This is the first pictures taken in 1983 from the site. This is a small road that goes from one Paşalar village to the closest village. And these are the first specimens collected from the locality in 1983. You can see there are very nice molars of medium-sized hominoid. And up to now, for almost 24 years, 32 years, this locality has been excavated by Professor Alpagut and her team. And these are the students from Ankara University Anthropology Department. Each year, they are working on the site for almost 2 months, and the site is as a laboratory for this students. And this is the location of the Paşalar, situated in the northwestern part of Turkey, very close to Dardanelles. Now, the Paşalar fauna, starting from 1991 to 2013, before my colleagues study on the large mammals, we have almost a very rich, more than 60 specimens collected from the site. Let's take a quick look. We have a rich murid and great rodent records. Again, we have very rich carnivore records, starting from amphitheons to mustelids and hyenids. We have very few ruminants, by the way. The boys represented by only 3 taxa. And we have only 1 cervid at that time, and we have a typical dress of middle Miocene, Geoffrocharis. Then we have micromeres. Swedes are really well represented at the site by Tolkanoma, Listerodon, and Bunolisterodon, and Conopius. Triglyph is a common element of middle Miocene, also in Turkey. Rhinos, we have rhinos of Brachiopotarium, and Popula Ceretarium and Borocolibondo Tecae. The hominoids, too, till 2007, the studies on the hominoids that revealed only 1 taxa, Gryphopithecus alpani. And later in 2007, thanks to the detailed studies on the existing material, they distinguished another specimen, and named as Canyopithecus kazuli. So this is also a very unique locality, which has also 2 different hominoids. Proboscideans up to that time, we have the typical medium-sized Deinotherium and Gompertherium Paşalarensis. It's a unique species, slightly different from a typical compactary fungus dens. And Tubulidenta, at that time we have very few fragments of Tubulidenta. Also we have very few fragments, only just two specimens belongs to Hyrax, here Hyrax. Also it's interesting, it's very interesting, we have again only one specimen belongs to Helicoptera. Now the fossil bones here, as you can see, concentrated in a single horizon, sort of sands and gravels, which were accumulated rapidly. We can see it's a pothole and which full of fossils accumulated on the pothole. According to preliminary studies on taphonomy, studied by Peter Andrews and his team, according to this study, the Paşalar fossils have a definition distribution pattern of surface weathering, which indicates low accumulation over a period of years. Up to from 1983 to 2013, almost 321 squares were excavated. It's a huge number according to Turkish standards. This is the old road which I had just shown you, the first picture. And from that first picture to 2014, you can see it's a huge area was excavated. And there's some material, yes. Now I'm going to show some pictures starting from 1980s till now. Now later on in 1975, after 2 years excavation, you can see the results of the extensive excavation. And we have, this is the solid sample of Hyrax and upper M1. And later on we are trying to find many, many carnivores. Most of them are broken pieces. Also, you can see some nice preserved insectivores. And later on, in 1987, 2 years later, thanks to extensive excavation, the team started to recover many, many, many fossils. And you can see the original position of the Gompetarium Bernard in here. And there are some nice canines of hominoids. Later on, the number of hominoids that had yielded from the locality started increasing and increasing, and now became a bit to an enormous number, like more than 2,000. It's something so regular to find hominoids at the site daily. You can see in 1986, these are just some incisor molars and premolars of incisors of Gynophapithecus and Hemipithecus in just one excavation season. In 1995, 55 taxa were reported, and but interestingly with some group, unfortunately, like carnivores and proboscideans, they were discussed briefly in the first monograph in 1990, which was published in Journal of Human Evolution Journal. At that time, around 1,000 hominoids were recovered and published. And these are again some materials categorized here. Like we have suets, we have the boids, we have this delicious molar of a Gompetarium, the beautiful canine of Listerdon, and giraffes we have. And this is a nice tusk of a Deinotherium. This is a single specimen of Calicoter. It's interesting, we didn't find anything up to that time. And cervids is very rare and just represented by the heteroprox. We revised the Siphonisemas of Ellen Gentry's determination as heteroprox. Now, what else we have for the other ruminants? We have Paleomerics, we have Geopacarics. And these are the two, the remaining monographs in 1990 and in 1995. In 1990 paper, a monograph mostly focused on the large mammals and micro mammals and their systematics. In 1995, the paper mostly focused on the geology and taphonomy and related subjects. As I told you, in 2008, in a special volume, Jay Kelly, Peter Andrews, and Berna Alpagut announced the second hominoid, Hemipithecus skizzylii, in a special paper in Journal of Human Evolution. And this is between 2007. You can see the numbers of Hominoids in the distribution. In from starting from 83 to 1996, you can see a huge recovery of Hominoids. There are too many reasons for this one. First of all, up to that time, the team was more than how can I say, the number of the team members were very much. And starting from 1996, since the excavation started with less numbers, so also that you can see the results getting decreased. Yes, these are some pictures from the team. There are some extra pictures. These are all is going to be published within this year by Turkish, German, and Spanish colleagues, which as on behalf of a new project. These are some rhinos, this planetarium, and we have this. Bowies, giraffes, and again the beautiful canyon of this. This is an instant model of this canyon you can see. Spark preserved. It's another canyon, and there here there's a beautiful preserved. I'm sorry, this awful preserved carnosid of an Alsacian and Tetraragus. And we have very few large we have very few recovered mandibles or maxilla. Complete ones, thanks to the awful taphonomy. Now in 2013 and between 2015, Turkey, Holland, Spain and Slovakia, the paleontologists, we converged at the Paşalar site to start to study the old collections, also the new collections. We have a large funnel extended from Slovakia, Peter Jonia, and from Madrid, we have Pablo. And this is today's the picture of the Paşalar site, and you can imagine this is this was the main road, and up to 32 years time, with more than 320 excavated squares, you can see the final version of Paşalar, and still need to be excavated more. The first results of this extensive study within these 2 years, last 2 years, we have revealed new taxa. For example, we have revealed the first Yenodontidae, Yenodorus. We have a beautiful mandible. Also, this is the first record in Turkey, in Miocene. Also, in Amphisyon, we have new species of Cynalus, new species of Amphisyon. Also, Turkish, the first report of Pseudarctos, which is a common element of Middle Miocene, mostly from Central Europe. And Gobicion. Gobicion is a very unique, very extraordinary carnivore, which has only two records in Middle Miocene in Eurasia. One is from Tungur, and the other is from Rebreza. So this is the third record from Middle Miocene. And we have also the first record of Leptoplacictis, and Protocytarium cingulatum, Corassum. And for again, we have Santonus pilus, another felid-like carnivore. We found Lepomeris for the gomphotheres. We also spotted Protonarchus new species. These records were particularly important as they will include new data and reveal peculiar paleogeographical connections and relations for local and eastern Mediterranean biostratigraphy. And taking into consideration these biochronological data, we prefer to correlate the Paşalar fauna early Middle Miocene, late MM5. The previous studies mostly focused on MM6, but with the addition of the new elements, now we are more confident as the Paşalar is much older than expected. And clearly older than the second hominoid fauna known as Chandan. The paleoecological data reflects subtropical season climate during early Middle Miocene and so on. The proboscideans, let's give you some small example from the proboscideans. They were all collected and published by the famous paleontologist from Libya, Gazi, in 1976. And he described four taxa: Gigantium, Androcidans, Saptoperodacus, and Paşalarensis, and gave these species. But in the first monograph, in Tobin, briefly, in the and provisionally reviewed the specimen report, and he just identified two species, Deuterium livius instead of Giganteum, and Paşalar ise, and he didn't mention subtopurides. And these are some pictures. This is the Paşalarensis mandible and Deuterium tusk, and this is Paşalarensis holotype. And this is some comments about the gum protein Deuterium. And according to this plot diagram of lower end 2, the Paşalar material really is definitely not gigantous. The size plus really well fits with Deuterium livius. And carnivore, it's interesting, we have in the old monograph, we have only two pages for carnivore, even though we have more than 1,000 carnassial found, 1,000 carnassial of Pancrocuta and Amphicion and others. It's a huge number, it's very hard to study, by the way. But unfortunately, this Turkish colleague of us, Mustafa Gürbüz, just gave minimum number of individuals numbers than just the list of the provisional fauna. And according to his study, we have 27 carnivores. Unfortunately, the taxonomy was very outdated at that time. And later, Suvi Bianca and Peter Anders studied the carnivore structure. And surprisingly, they decreased the number of the carnivores, and they just studied very few of them, 30 of them. Here we have the first Sinalus, a new species from Paşalar, and comparing with Sinalus helvingi, which is very common of Winterschopfest, well, type locality of the man tree, and Demonensis from the famous locality of Ulm, and the Sabuncubeli, Sinalus boemicus, or Amphicion boemicus, the taxonomy is still controversial. Yes, the Paşalar and this. I don't want to tell the morphological differences and systematics lately, but they are clearly morphological, especially the talonic basin, so different between each other. The Turkish material, the Paşalar material, the hypoconic lingual is shaded, but in the Helvingi, which is common in all early middle Miocene, it is the Turkish one is the veil is shaded. And Gobsion, let's see this interesting material. Gobsion, this is the Tungur material from National History Museum in New York. It was published by Colbert in 1989, and up to that time, I couldn't find any publication related to this one. This is an... And taxonomy is very interesting nowadays. Some of the paleontologists consider the Gobsion as belongs to Amphicyonidae. Some of them says no, it is Canidae, and some of them still continue to support Borocophinae. The material is here. This one, we have this, and this is the Tungur material. Our material is morphologically slightly different and larger than the original one. Yes, you see the Paşalar and Rebreza and Tungur material. It's so interesting to find this material in Turkey. Also, lately in 2014, we found some extra material of Gobsion. And Pseudarctos, it's well represented in our site. We have beautiful carnassials and upper molars, which fits with this fallen material of Barbaricus. It really fits with the MS6 records. And this is Amphicion new species. Actually, this is the largest Amphicion in the world. It is more larger than the Amphicion ingens of America, larger than any European Amphicion, and Amphicion mostly from larger than Giganteus. And we have something like 15 specimens here. I just want to share one carnassial and one lower than two from here. And you may see the size of Giganteus, and Paşalar, it's really huge, also N2. It doesn't fit anything with this. Also, the morphology is quite peculiar. And just, do I have time? No. Okay, so thank you.